Continuing our coverage, itchy eyes, runny nose, sore throat, all those symptoms from the bad air quality in our state caused by the Pole Creek and Bald Mountain fires. Experts say they saw spikes in hazardous levels yesterday in southern Utah County. News for Utah's Rosie Nguyen joins us live now from Spanish Fork with how you can protect your lungs from the smoke. And I think all of us have been feeling and smelling that bad air, Rosie.
Today, the Utah Department of Environmental Quality says they see the worst air levels during the morning. They recommend staying indoors for as long as you can until that bad air clears up in the afternoon. But for those that have to work outdoors, they say that's just not possible. Robert and Barbara Powell Freeman wake up bright and early to set their produce stand on the side of Main Street in Spanish Fork. They say normally they love what they do. But for the past few days, it's been difficult.
When we get here in the morning, you can smell it just in the air. I have lung allergies, and so I'm using medication and some over-the-counter stuff just to keep being here.
I have some heart problems, and it's been really bad. A little bit of a sore throat, not a lot, but it's just miserable.
The Utah Department of Environmental Quality says they started to see high levels of fine microscopic particulates called PM2.5 in the air from the wildfires. These types of particulates tend to stay in the air for a long time, and once we breathe it in, it can bypass the natural filters in our nose and throats and get lodged in our lungs.
This increases inflammation in the lungs. It can cross over to the cardiovascular system, and that can make cases of asthma or bronchitis or any of those other pre-existing conditions worse.
Mendenhall says this is what you can do to protect your lungs from the smoke. Avoid outdoor activity as much as possible. Close all doors and windows in your house. Don't rely on dust masks. Keep your indoor air clean. And when you're in the car, make sure you recirculate it. But for those that work outdoors,
we don't have a choice. This thing runs from 7 to 6. It's our job. The same as the firefighters' job, same as anybody else's. You just have to put up with it and do your work.
Mendenhall says to keep an eye out on those who are the most at risk. You have children, the elderly, and those with pre-existing conditions. He says to listen to your body and to take a break whenever needed. Reporting live in Spanish Fork, Rosie Nguyen, News 4 Utah.
Rosie, thank you.